Inez Mendez, you wanted me to speak about my fasting routine. So I can definitely do that for you. Diet is obviously a very individual thing because, like anything else, our dietary preferences and habits, they vary from individual based on so many factors. So as always, I'm just going to speak to my experience because that's the only one that I can draw from is my own experience. So I started fasting in, it was March 2017. That period of time coincided with me implementing a therapeutic ketogenic diet. Prior to that, from 2008, August, to 2017, March, that entire period of time, I didn't eat meat. So I was lacking in many nutrients, and this is my body I'm talking about again. I just want to make that very clear, and in no way is anything I say meant to be prescriptive. You should not do what I do. You should not eat what I eat. I'm just sharing. So I started eating a therapeutic ketogenic diet in early 2017, in March of 2017, in fact, because my body, what I've learned now since then, it was that my body was lacking fat, specifically dietary fat, and it was sorely lacking cholesterol. And cholesterol feeds the brain. We need cholesterol. My mental health, I should say, was suffering a great deal in the form of anxiety, mood disturbances, because of this lack of dietary fat and cholesterol and omega-3s from animal products. These things were lacking. I was eating a bounty of omega-3s from plants, but ever since I started implementing animal foods and animal fat in particular, my mood, my everything has been, it's been like night and day for me. Dietary change was very necessary for me, and I did a lot of tweaking to my diet and experimentation because I am a firm believer in research, of course, but research is not a substitute for actually applying that research or applying that knowledge, experimenting on myself. So that's exactly what I did. Like I said, I had already gone 8-9 years without eating meat, so I knew what that felt like. And then I started to eat more fattier cuts of fish, fatty meats, organ meats, bone broth, bone marrow, tallow. I started including these foods in my diet, and cod liver, things like this. So I have benefited greatly from that. Apart from the diet, the reason I fast, well, there are many reasons I fast, but fasting is a great way for me to regulate my hunger. I struggled for many years of my life with a dysregulation of food intake in the form of overeating, undereating, emotionally eating, you name it. So that was obviously causing a host of deleterious effects on my, again, my mood and my overall well-being that I needed to take responsibility for and address. So I did, and fasting has been the correction method, a solution for me. It's given me the freedom, frankly, to not be fixated on food. Apart from autophagy, which is why many people nowadays fast, autophagy literally means self-eating, and that's a process by which the damaged proteins in the cells and the mitochondria, they're scavenged and recycled, and then new cells, new fresh young cells can grow in their place. So there's a big, you know, uptake in people fasting nowadays because of its anti-aging benefits and its longevity impact. But the thing that I like most about fasting is that I'm not preoccupied with food, and I can simply listen to my body's hunger signals. I tend to get hungry around the 20-hour mark. Sometimes I get hungrier depending on my hormones and what time of the month it is for me. Sometimes I get hungrier around the 18-hour mark or earlier. And if I do, I always listen to that. I listen to my hunger signals and then I feed my body. And it's so freeing because not only is it freeing mentally, but the food I eat is so much more enjoyed by me when I'm in a state of true physical hunger and my appetite is wet, rather than me turning to food for emotional comfort or a self-soothing mechanism. So in that way, for that purpose alone, I am a huge fan of intermittent fasting for that reason. But of course, it does have a host of other benefits as well. I've seen some videos on Dr. Eric Berg's channel, where he talks about the skin tightening effect of fasting. So that's intriguing and a bonus that I will definitely take if that's, you know, that can go along with it, then why not? But for me, just a day-to-day intermittent fasting is what I practice, and I'm not dogmatic about it at all. I simply listen to my body. So that it really does, I keep using that word, but it really simplifies my life, purely listening to my body's own wisdom and my natural hunger cues. Another thing you asked about was how I get my nutrients. I focus on nutrient density rather than counting any kind of macros or calories or anything like that. So I eat extremely nutrient dense foods like organ meats, red meat occasionally. I eat fatty cuts of fish with the skin. And if it's canned fish, I eat the soft bones for calcium. I eat things like cod liver periodically to dose my body with natural vitamin D and omega-3 fatty acids. I eat whole avocados on a daily basis, so that's a very nutrient-dense, fatty food, very good, rich source of nourishment. I focus on my fullness, so I eat to satiety. I don't restrict myself. I don't limit my food quantity. So when I'm fasting, I'm fasting. So I'm drinking water and that's about it. Maybe green tea and one cup of coffee in the morning, but I'm drinking plain water. So that's fasting. And then when I'm feasting, I feast and I eat to my heart's content and I choose the foods that are going to nourish me completely. And when you choose whole foods like that, and I don't eat processed foods either, so it's once in a blue moon that I have something that's processed or that I didn't prepare myself. It's a focus on nutrition and a focus on balance of nutrients, and I also listen to my body in that way. Around my cycle, for instance, I can tell that I need to eat some red meat for the iron and the B12, and those are the times when I beef up, no pun intended, my red meat consumption so that I can nourish my body for that period of time, and it works very harmoniously. And likewise, if I'm feeling a little sluggish or tired, I know that I need to add more fat, nutrient-dense foods. So I focus on the nutrients, and when you focus on whole nutrient-dense foods, I find at least you don't need to worry about or, you know, you don't need to concern yourself with all the numbers and am I getting enough of this, that, and the other, because your body, my body, I should say, indicates to me by how I feel. So I go off of that, and I think that's the best indicator that I have is how I feel. How is my sleep? How is my skin? How is my, you know, the quality of my hair and my fingernails and my mood? Mood is a big one. How is my elimination, my digestion? All of these markers will tell me if I need to tweak my diet, and then I do so, and then I can be very in tune with my body. You know, I know in this day and age, it seems especially that people who are not in the functional medicine sphere, it seems unfortunately that a lot of doctors rely on the sickness of their patients to keep them in business, frankly. So it doesn't bode well for the person, does it, if you are sick or unwell? I'm not discounting medications or anything, but so many of these problems can be mitigated and treated, actually, by exercise and diet and lifestyle implementations. And I have seen so many clients, and I have seen so many of my colleagues cure and treat their own health problems using functional medicine on very simple factors. But the one thing I will say is that these these practices, they require discipline, they require consistency, effort, energy, willingness, and they require one taking responsibility for your own body and being an advocate for your own health. And I'm not sure if that's something that everyone is ready or willing or able to do. But I know for me, it's been the best, greatest gift I've given to myself. I've gotten my parents on board too with intermittent fasting, and they love it. Ines, I hope that was helpful for you and anyone that might have been curious about my fasting lifestyle. I don't take any supplements. I take vitamin D only in a form of a liquid supplement that contains just vitamin D and olive oil. It's 2,000 international units, so I can use my discretion and use one drop or two. And if you have any questions based on what I've shared, please leave them in the comments below. I wish you well, and you shall see me soon. Bye.